In this tutorial, we'll be looking at the basic functions of the software and the different screens in the Graphical User Interface, or GUI. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, and welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the chimp hardware keys as keys, and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. The graphical user interface is divided into three sections: a top toolbar, a content area, and a bottom toolbar. Let's start with the top toolbar. The top toolbar is subdivided into three sections. The left-hand section provides access to the various programmer and playback screen settings. The middle section provides information on the current show, display buttons for the fader and executor page settings, and provides information on the time code. The right-hand section of the top toolbar contains buttons for saving settings, managing shows, and locking the chimp. Back to the left-hand section of the top toolbar, use this section to select the four different screens of the content area: programming, playback, quad split, and half split. We will delve into more detail in the content area later in this tutorial. The middle section contains the fader and executor page buttons. Further information on these functions can be found in the playback, fader, and executor pages tutorial. In addition, this section also contains the reset timecode and timecode enabled buttons and displays the current timecode. We will delve into more detail in the timecode tutorial. Let's look more at the right-hand section of the top toolbar. The first button is Setup. Press Setup to go to the settings for the Infinity Chimp Lite controller. On the left-hand side, we can see all possible settings for the chimp. The chimp settings are subdivided into show settings, system settings, maintenance, and licensing. At the very bottom is the button for closing the chimp. Further information on all settings is provided in the general setup tutorial. Let's go back to the right-hand section of the top toolbar and the second button, Backup. Pressing the Backup button opens the show management overview. This is subdivided into current show and managed shows. Current show provides information on your current show. Managed show provides information on all other shows that have been saved in the chimp. The following button on the right-hand side of the top toolbar is the Lock Console button, which allows you to lock the chimp. The lock code is set to 0000 by default. We'll cancel this action. The code can be changed. To do this, click on Setup at the top right of the toolbar. In Setup, we go to Show Settings. Here you will find the Change PIN button at the top right of the overview screen. Enter the current PIN. The default is 0000, then enter a new PIN. The chimp then asks you to enter the PIN again to confirm it. The final button in the top toolbar is the Quick Save button. This is used to save the show before it is finished. The text turns green when the show has been successfully saved. Shows are saved to the internal drive. Shows can be saved automatically at different time intervals. To do this, press the Backup button. This takes you to the show management overview, then select Autosave at the top left of the screen. There are a number of different options here. These will be looked at in more detail in the backup Manage Shows tutorial. Bottom toolbar. Now we'll look at the bottom toolbar. The bottom toolbar occupies the entire width of the bottom of the screen. The toolbar is subdivided into three sections. On the left-hand side, we can see the 10 executor labels. This corresponds with the faders on the keyboard. Each label contains various status information relating to the corresponding cue. The Programming Creating Cues tutorial will look at this in more detail. The middle section of the bottom toolbar displays the 10 executor labels for the corresponding executor buttons. These executor labels also contain status information. On the right-hand side is the master fader, information for the corresponding fader located below. This also displays status information. Above the master fader information are the programmer tools, fan mode, and selection. Let's go back to the middle section where we find more than just executor labels. If we select a fixture, we see the labels above the executor populated with encoder labels. These names correspond with the four encoders that can be found below. The area in which the executor labels are located is also used by the programmer to display various tool options. For example, press fan mode above the master fader labels. The executor labels now move temporarily to make space for the fan mode toolbar. The area in which the encoder labels are located is also used by the programmer for the command line. Press the Rec Hardware button. We can now see that the space for the encoder labels makes space for the command line, and the area for the executor labels makes space for the various record options. Content Area Programming. As mentioned earlier, the middle section of the screen has two functions, programming and playback. Press Programming on the left of the top toolbar. We can now see the programming layout in the content area. In this case, the layout has four sections on the screen. At the bottom right is a fixed section containing information about the attributes that are available. The other three sections can be split up as required. We call these screens split widgets. To the left of the split widgets is a menu in which the desired split widgets can be selected. The following split widgets are available: fixtures, groups, presets, cue list view, executors, and cue lists. The cue lists split widget displays all programmed cues and cue lists for the show. The standard layout of the split widgets for programming is presets on the right-hand side and fixtures and groups on the left-hand side. The split widgets can, however, be laid out as you prefer. The fixtures split widget contains an output visualizer. This displays the output information of the patched fixture. Let's, for example, select the IS-100 group. This turns the IS-100 fixtures green. If we now press the full hardware button, the bars on the left turn blue. This gives us dimmer information. If we are selecting a color for a fixture, as here with the color picker, it is indicated in the output visualizer. The output visualizer also displays gobo information. And if we turn to the pan and tilt encoders, we can see the position information. Content Area Playback. The middle section is also used for playback mode. Press playback in the top toolbar. The screen is now split into three. The standard split for the playback mode is the Cue List View Split widget on the right-hand side and the two split widgets, Fixtures and Executors, on the left-hand side. You can also split the playback view with other split widgets. Playback mode can also be divided into Quad Split and Half Split View. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.